Top of the morning, everyone. This is your friend and fellow trader, Doug Campbell, coming to you with the morning market preparation video for November 2nd, 2018. So, hey, everyone, we had some news last night that got the market all fired up. We are indicated to open sharply higher this morning. But hey, before we jump into that, if you would give me just a second, please do me a favor, click that subscribe button on YouTube. If this is the first time you've seen these videos, let me explain here just a second that I don't intend to ever make money from these videos. That's not my point with doing this. I truly do this to try and help other traders do a better job with their market preparation for the day. So if you find these helpful, please click that subscribe button on YouTube, the follow me button on Facebook, click those thumbs up buttons and drop a comment. I truly, truly appreciate it. You guys have been awesome. Thank you very much for doing that. And by the way, I want to celebrate because yesterday we went over 2,000 subscribers. Thank you to everyone who has participated. You guys are the best. So with that, everyone, hey, we've got a happy, happy market this morning. Right now, the Dow futures are indicated to gap the market higher by over 300 points this morning. So the news was that President Trump and China are working out or trying to work out a trade deal. It looks like they're moving closer to getting that done. So, of course, that changes everything. The market really loves that news popping up sharply here this morning. And if we take a look, we're indicated to open up somewhere up in this range here, meaning that we blew right through that resistance that we struggled with yesterday, popping up through here and moving up toward, actually even above that 34 exponential moving average, and now potentially working to stretch out toward that 50-day moving average in the Dow chart, leaping higher. This is going to be an interesting morning because anyone caught short this market is going to feel some interesting pain this morning, some nasty pain this morning as they experience what we call a short squeeze in the market, where anyone caught short is pushed to a position where they're forced to buy to cover, and that can actually push the market even higher on its own. So what an amazing rally that we are seeing this morning. But let's talk about a couple things. Hey, by the way, do me a favor here, everyone. Stick around to the end of the video. I've got a couple of trade ideas for maybe your watch list for next week. So stick around for that. If we take a look right in here, we're bouncing up toward a level of resistance. So right in here, we have our next level of price resistance. And we can draw this line right across here. It's fairly clear. And that is just right there at that 50-day moving average. So we have a significant level of resistance that we're still beneath, which means even though the market is very happy, very, very bullish this morning, keep in mind, we still have a lot of technical damage to recover from. Now, that doesn't mean you have to necessarily fear the market or anything here, but I do think when we have moved more than 1,400 points in 4 days, we should expect the possibility, not that it will happen, the possibility of some profit taking coming in before the weekend. So we want to watch that. Now, I will tell you that one of the market patterns that is very rare to see in the market is the market pattern that they call a V bottom. Now, a V bottom is when we get that true move down and then a strong move back up, and we create that V pattern. Well, I got to tell you, with this possibility of a trade deal being inked between the US and China, I think it could be a game changer that we could actually experience a true V bottom here and a true game changer for the end of the year. So let's keep an eye on that, but we want to be careful not to chase and not to rush. There's plenty of time here to make really good money in the market. So Remember, huge gap up means the possibility that we could see some selling before the end of the day, just some profit taking coming in. So be careful how you plan your risk going into the weekend. Let's take a look at the SPY. SPY looking really good this morning. Again, yesterday we were challenged by this resistance, and now this news blowing through that resistance very strongly. Now, we do have an additional challenge here in the SPY. You can see this rally up this morning will just come right back up here to the 200-day moving average. So we have to keep in mind, we still have a lot of technical damage in the chart that we still need to repair. And that technical damage could create some selling and some issues for us. So don't expect us to just scream higher and never stop, okay? There will be some challenges that we'll have to deal with. And also keep in mind that volatility is still high enough. And with the earnings calendar, only about 100 companies reporting today, but next week, about 1,500 companies report, which means volatility is likely to remain very high. So be prepared for that challenging price action and some considerable whip in the market. Also, remember, midterm elections are just around the corner, and that's been kind of weighing heavily on the market. Of course, the trade deal could certainly overwhelm those concerns, but just kind of keep in mind that we still have some challenges ahead of us, not only technically in the charts, but in the news itself. Let's take a look at the Qs. Now, the Qs have been really, they really suffered a lot under this trade war issue, and we stopped short yesterday of breaking through that 200-day moving average. Now, I want you to notice, even though the Dow is gapping up and the SPY is gapping up substantially this morning, the Qs are not feeling the same love. Qs are getting a little bit of a pop, and one of the reasons is because of Apple. Apple reported earnings after the bell yesterday. And you can see Apple is indicated to open substantially lower, a little bit over 5.5% lower this morning. They kind of disappointed the market. So that is going to be affecting the Qs this morning, and a little bit of a challenge here as we try to pop through that 200-day moving average and try and hold on to that. So watch that closely. If the Qs start slipping south, that could certainly begin to drag the rest of the indexes a little bit lower. So keep that in mind. Let's take a look at IWM. Now, IWM, I had suggested earlier this week, IWM may be the place to look for a potential trade long, and that certainly has worked out. And I even took a trade short on this for just 45 minutes yesterday on that, but I'm sure glad I closed it because we moved up sharply and now we're gapping higher this morning on IWM. IWM putting in a bottom, breaking the downtrend, starting to look pretty good here overall. But remember, we still have a long ways to go to recover. We are well below the 200-day moving average. Let's notice that the 50-day moving average is sliding south fast, and a potential cross of that 200-day moving average could potentially happen. So we all know a 50 crossing through the 200, they call that the death cross. Hopefully that isn't the case for the market. So watch that closely. Lots of technical damage to be repaired here in this market. Let's look at the VIX. Now, the VIX moved down again yesterday, and this morning I would expect it's probably going to gap lower. And here we have this level of support in here. We really want to see that fear drop below into here and maybe come right back into these support levels in here. For those that test. So if we can start breaking down and start placing more of a downtrend in fear, that would be wonderful for the market, and we could see a little bit of relaxation for those of us who trade options, option prices, the volatility of those option prices pulling back just a little bit and providing better prices for us. Let's take a look at T21. T21-22. This is my worry this morning. T21-22, we have rallied up sharply here in the last few days, extremely sharply. Now, we've been oversold down here for a while, so the fact that we're rallying, not a big surprise, but this morning's open is going to probably push T21-22 very close to that bearish reversal zone. So we're going to have to watch that closely. If we force this up here too high, too fast, we just automatically run the risk of bringing those profit takers in to pull this back. So watch this today. This could get a little bit crazy. Going from extreme oversold in short term to extreme overbought in a short term, and could easily bring those profit takers in. So watch that and be really careful about chasing into the market today. So with that, how about we take a look at our economic calendar here? If we take a look at the economic calendar, we have some big items on the calendar this morning. We have that employment situation number, those big employment numbers coming out. So we'll want to keep an eye on that. We have international trade and factory orders also. And then we're going to have just a little bit more of a calming in the market after that. On the earnings calendar, we have about 100 companies reporting earnings this morning. Quite a few notables in there, so you want to pay attention to that. And the volatility of this market could be extreme at the open. We could see a lot of really, really fast price action, a lot of whip. Even the dreaded pop and drop pattern would not be out of the question if we hop clear up here this morning and sellers come in and the NASDAQ gets some pressure to sell off. We could see that pop and drop pattern occur and a lower close on the morning. So watch that closely and be careful not to chase. So, hey, a couple trade ideas that I want to bring your attention to. One of them is CZZ. CZZ is a utilities company. Now, this is a little guy, but man, what a nice pattern we have here on CZZ. Nice little downtrend. The downtrend broke. It held its support. We've lifted above this resistance area, and we're starting to see bullishness as we're holding this support here to move higher. So CZZ might be one to put on your watch list for a potential trade. As you know, I mentioned FireEye the other day, and FireEye, my goodness, that thing is just taken off here. We broke that downtrend on the weekly, and you can see here's that weekly break of the downtrend, hold, and then we're firing up here on the buyers on the weekly chart. On the daily chart, I would say we have extended too far to chase that trade. Wait for the next entry into the position, but we have some good things going on here in FireEye. And then last but not least, UAA. UAA has struggled. You can see breaking down, but we've started to repair that here just recently, and we put in an interesting candle pattern. Now, this is a candle pattern. You won't find it in any book. I call this a Fig Newton pattern because we have the light cookie on the outside and the dark filling on the inside. Fig Newton patterns are usually very, very bullish patterns where we sandwich a bearish candle between two very bullish candles. And that Fig Newton generally leads the market or leads the stock higher. Now, I would tell you because of this pattern, this was a big gap on earnings. We could easily see the stock continue to consolidate in here for a period of time, a little bit of rest. But watch this in here. I think UAA with this pattern has a high potential of moving higher over the next couple of weeks or months. So watch that closely on UAA. Something to add to your list, not necessarily actionable maybe today, but something to pay attention to as we move forward. So hey everyone, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great profits. Thank you very much for all your support and helping us reach 2,000 subscribers. You guys are awesome. Thank you very much. And I will see you all right back here, bright and early, Monday morning. Have a great weekend, everyone.